you, Rajeev.
Hello and welcome to Now Showing. I'm Rajeev Masand and this is your guide to weekend entertainment. Started very early when I became a journalist. I started working very early. I started at the age of 16. I became a journalist while I had just, when I just finished school and I was entering college. I was very lucky that the Times of India actually hired me when I was 16. They took me on as a sort of trainee till I graduated, but I was full time. I mean, for all practical purposes, I mean, you know, for a 16-year-old kid to be walking into the Times of India building and you know, where all the great editors and the great journalists have worked, that was just a great high. These are all my colleagues from Bombay Times. Some of them I'm in touch with. Swapna, my friend, who lives in Singapore now. Malvika, who I'm still in touch with. That's Priya Bala, who's a big famous author. Malika. I mean, these are some of my my first job, the Times of India. These are old colleagues of mine. This was one of my big, big moments as a film journalist. This was recently in Paris, and Tom Cruise is one of the most charming people I've ever met. It was one of those incredible opportunities to interview two of the biggest global heartthrobs, Brad Pitt and Shah Rukh Khan. This happened last year when Brad Pitt was in India to promote his new Netflix film, and I had the opportunity to moderate a conversation between them, which was just one of the great opportunities. Again, these are the moments that make up the career. This is incredible. My favorite memory, I think, of the roundtables would be the first actors roundtable that we shot. It was late in the night. We had Ranbir Kapoor, we had Aamir Khan, we had Nawazuddin Siddiqui and Irfan Khan, who were all meant to show up at Taj Lands End. And actually, quite late, we got a call. About 1 hour before the shoot, we got a call saying that Irfan wasn't going to be able to come. And I remember just thinking, we're in trouble, we're dead, because it doesn't work with just three actors. I remember calling Irfan and begging him, but he was shooting a film for Yash Raj Films, and at that time it was his first film for that banner, and you know, the shoot had extended longer than he'd imagined. He couldn't leave. I was like, that doesn't work for me, you have to make this happen. I remember calling up a bunch of filmmakers who work with him, who know him, and beg them to, you know, put in a word and tell him, please come, please come, please come. He did finally come, very, very upset. He really didn't want to be disturbed. I pulled him out of a shoot and called him, which is really not what I like to do, but it had to be done. Each of them has a very special place in my heart. This one, because it was the first big one, I think we were nervous and we were excited. And when it happened, I just remember thinking, oh my God, will this ever happen again? I'm actually a Mumbai boy, born and bred in Mumbai. I live with my parents. I'm married, but I live with my parents because I'm mama's boy. So I have a wonderful set of parents. I have my wife that I live with. We're a great sort of nuclear family. I have my brother who lives down the road with his wife. My grandmom also lives with us. She's 96 years old. My wife's a journalist. We met when we were working at the Indian Express years ago. My family's not in films at all. My parents are retired, and really making them happy is one of the great goals in life. This is a picture of the family. This is a picture of my wonderful, wonderful extended family. My parents are in here. There's my dad. There's my mum. You've met my wife Shraddha. That's my cousin Anish. That's my cousin Manav. That's my brother Gautam. Shweta's the sister-in-law, Shweta and Shruti. Family picture. This is. I'm happy because they're in my life. The late Roger Ebert, one of the greatest film critics of our times. I mean, he was a huge inspiration. I never had the opportunity to meet him, which is one of my regrets. I was in Cannes around the same time that he was in Cannes 1 year, but it just never happened. And it's one of those life's regrets. I wish I could meet. He was my hero. He was my idol. I definitely want to jump out of a plane once and do a skydiving thing. I mean, I don't know if the parachute will open with my weight. I might go straight to the ground. May not be a good idea, but I feel like that's something I'd like to try. I'd like to meet some people. There are some people. I'm a huge fan of an actress called Emma Thompson. On my bucket list, definitely to meet Emma Thompson. I really want to go to Hawaii. I don't know what I'll do in Hawaii, given that I won't go into the water. I'm petrified of beaches and the sea, as I told you. But going to Hawaii is also on my bucket list. The man who changed my life, Spielberg, because it's his films, Jaws and E.T., that had the greatest impact on my life. The film that changed my life is Jaws. I don't know if many people know this. I was about 8 years old. I don't know what my parents were thinking. Which responsible parents take their 8-year-old son to watch Jaws? I mean, that is the movie that I think was one of the first movie experiences I remember watching in the theater. I remember being petrified of my life of sharks. When I met Mr. Spielberg, when he came to India and I interviewed him, I told him, my family has a complaint against you. They really are upset that because of you and because of Jaws, I will not go on beach holidays. So he actually apologized and he signed in my book saying that I'm really sorry for scaring you off the ocean. It's funny because I know it feels like that's my competition. That's Anupama Chopra, who's a dear, dear friend and a contemporary. This actually was taken at the Mumbai Film Festival Mela, the Mami Mela, which is the property we created together. And I remember to this picture, Deepika actually wrote, had tweeted back saying, looking good. I think she was talking about my weight and the fact that that this bum kind of looks almost as big as my own. So I think that's why she tweeted. But Anu is one of my dearest friends. She's someone who I have a lot of, we do a lot of work together. We do a podcast together. We do the Mela together. We are part of the Film Critics Circle together. And she's really one of those dear friends of mine who also inspires me. And who shows me that as big as you are, and as you know, as popular as you are, and as rich as you are, and that's no reason for you to stop working and stop working hard. She really sets the bar very high, and I really enjoy sort of collaborating with her. Two tattoos which say "Believe and Imagine." There's this one. I hope you can see it.
I'm in.
And there's this one which says "Imagine." Anyone who knows me knows that I'm obsessed with Star Wars. I was wearing a Star Wars t-shirt. I was wearing my Star Wars shoes. What you can't see in this picture is that I was also wearing my Star Wars underwear and my Star Wars socks. That you don't get to see in this picture. You just have to take my word for it. So I'm going to take you around a tour of the CNN Mumbai Bureau office. This is where I've spent 13 years of my life, and it's true. We started in a little loft, but we spent the chunk of the time here. So I'm going to show you the edit bays first. This edit bay is where we edit Now Showing, the review show that I do. They're editing an interview that I did with Manav Kaul and Radhika Apte. That is Vishal Chakkara, my producer, who has been my producer for many, 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 many years. He's my brother, my producer, my everything. He worked with me for 13 years here, and before that he was my producer at Star News as well. He's the only man I trust with my footage and I trust with my work. I leave it to him and I know it'll be magic at the end. Oh, this is where Vipul, who has been producing my show for the longest time, is. Vipul is editing something for the week that wasn't. Mohit is my other dear friend, who's the other sort of last man standing here. Also been here for, I've lost count. Yeah. Mohit's been here as long as I have. So this is the newsroom. This is where the CNN-IBN site sits. That last desk there is mine. You see the Lucasfilm bottle. That's from the Star Wars. I bought it from ILM. That's Nikita, who's one of our gems. Nikita works for the web team, but she's pretty incredible. That's Rituraj. Rituraj is also in my team. We work together. Rituraj is a reporter on our team. He's done a great story, which I have just cut up and asked him to make changes to. So he's going to do some changes. But this is the newsroom. This is where the news is. That's Sunil. Sunil is head of news camera team. Sunil is one of those great journalists. I'll never forget how Sunil very often used to give me feedback. Now he doesn't give me feedback on my reviews also. And Sunil, I really look forward to it. Sunil is the most practical person, which I think is something that we were missing, and and I think she fills that. And then there's Vinaya, who's my friend, and of course our head of bureau in Mumbai. So this is where all the magic happens. This is Studio 4, where I shoot Now Showing. We've been shooting in this studio for many years. Now I'm going to take you inside the PCR, which is the room from where all the Astons are fired, all the basically the core team of technicians who make sure that I'm anchoring properly. This is where actually the magic happens. I'm a puppet over there. This is where they make the magic happen. So I hope you enjoyed this sort of tour around our workspace. I'm going to finally end where I sit, which is actually my desk, which is where I work from. This is where I work from. It's a messy desk, please forgive me. There's always coffee, there's always water, and inevitably there's something to eat. Today there's some cake and there's some chocolate. That's just how I am. I didn't get fat on fresh air and water. This is why I am like this. This is the story of my life. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like, share, and subscribe.